As the Prime Minister stated, effective March 18th at noon, Canada will deny boarding to all foreign nationals on flights to Canada other than transborder flights, in other words, flights from the U.S., and to any foreign national who has resided outside of Canada or the United States in the last 14 days. The measure will not apply to Canadian citizens and permanent residents, immediate family members of citizens, or permanent residents. To air crews, to travelers in transit to another country, and to diplomats. Any passenger, regardless of citizenship, with possible COVID-19 symptoms will not be allowed to board flights to Canada. In addition, effective March 18th at 12:01 a.m., in other words, a minute past midnight on Tuesday, all flights from Europe, Asia, Africa, and South America will be diverted to the Montreal, Toronto, Calgary, and Vancouver airports. Flights from the U.S., the Caribbean, and Mexico can continue to land at their scheduled Canadian destinations.
By limiting international flights to our four main airports, it allows for the concentration and efficient use of our limited resources. As we will identify ill passengers before they arrive, they'll be met at the gate by border security officers, isolated from passenger processing areas, and referred immediately to public health officials. And finally, by significantly reducing the number of non-Canadian travelers, we will see a significant reduction in those traveling to Canada, and therefore a reduction in those who need to be processed.
Canada and the United States have the longest unmilitarized border in the world, and that border, we all know, is absolutely vital to the daily life of people who live on both sides of that border.
Canadians are worried about their food supply. This is a real thing and a live thing in North America, where we have an integrated economy, integrated supply chains, and where both countries rely on each other to provide essential goods that include foods and other products for our homes, etc., including medications. So it's very important that we do this with a degree of precision and in the spirit of a strong relationship that much of the work that we've done in previous on things like NAFTA has been conducted. And that's the work that we're doing right now. We'll have more to say in the days to come.